Nirmam Equities welcomes you all to the Q3 FY21 earning conference call of Solar Industries India Limited. The management is represented by Mr. Manish Nuwal, Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer, Mr. Nilesh Panpalia, Chief Financial Officer, and Mr. Suresh Menon, Executive Director. I now hand over the call to the management for their opening remarks, post which we can take questions from participants. Over to you, sir.
Hello everyone and welcome to the earnings call of Solar Industries India Limited to discuss Q3 FY21 earnings release. This is Nilesh Panpalia, CFO, Solar Industries India Limited. Joining us today on this call is CEO and MD Mr. Manish Nuwal, Executive Director Mr. Suresh Menon, along with other members of senior management team. We will start the call with some remarks on the performance of the company by myself and Mr. Manish Nuwal before we open up the call for questions. Please note that anything that we say which refers to our outlook for the future is a forward-looking statement which must be heard and read in conjunction with the risk that the company faces. A full statement and explanation of this risk is available in our filings with the regulatory authorities, which can be found on stock exchange websites. With this, I would like to pass it on to Mr. Manish Nuwal for his opening remarks.
Myself, Manish Nuwal, a very good afternoon to all the valued investors. We are happy to announce that with our team's focused efforts and customer support, company have shown significant improvement in its performance in this quarter. And as a result, we have surpassed 9 months revenue, EBITDA and PBT despite of pandemic challenges. We have seen improvements in demand from housing infra and coal mining. And as a result, sales have reached to pre-COVID levels in this quarter as far as demand from Indian market is concerned. We can see increased sales from Q4 onwards. And as far as sales from exports and overseas is concerned, it is doing pretty good and improvements are quite visible in our performance. We expect it to improve further as we move forward. As far as defense is concerned, sales in Q3 was lower than our expectations. It is mainly due to deferment of deliveries and shipments by our customers. However, we expect continuous improvements from Q4 onwards as deliveries for Grenade is also likely to start. Our total order book stands at 1635 crores, which includes orders from defense products at 678 crores. I am pleased to inform you that in light of the country's expected economic growth, with a particular emphasis on infrastructure development and mining, the board of directors have approved a significant expansion of the manufacturing capacity of packaged explosives. This will enable us to set up 3 greenfield packaged explosives plants to increase its geographical reach and customer satisfaction. Overall, our company is in a pretty good position and we are confident of overcoming near-term challenges and create sustainable value for its stakeholders. Further, going forward, we are optimistic and gives us comfort in committing a better year than financial year 20 despite of pandemic. Now I will request Mr. Nilesh to take you through the financials. Thank you.
And as we review the Q3 result, recall we are comparing over a quarter where no one had ever heard of COVID-19. The consolidated revenue is up by 14.67%. That is 645.85 crores compared to 563.23 crores. The domestic explosive revenue is up by 0.17%. That is 278.67 crores compared to 278.20 crores. Our domestic explosive volume are almost flat. That is 86,265 metric tons compared to 86,387 metric tons. Domestic realization of explosives have improved marginally by say 0.31%. That is 32,304 per ton compared to 32,204 on account of commodity prices. Initiating system revenue has increased by 24.4%, that is 91.50 crores compared to 73.55 crores. And when we talk about the revenue mix, Coal India as a percentage of revenue stands at 15% for Q3 FY21. In absolute terms, it is 97.89 crores compared to 89.99 crores. In the basket, non-Coal India and institutional revenue has decreased by 9%, but now it has shown signs of improvement. And even when we compare to previous quarter, it is better. In absolute terms, it is 73.13 crores compared to 80.74 crores. In housing and infra, the revenue is up by 27%, that is from 130.77 crores to 166.05 crores. And as told to you by our MD that we are seeing a promising Q4. The export and overseas revenue show an increase of 27% from 221.59 crores to 280.42 crores. The defense revenue is down by 11% from 25.79 crores to 22.92 crores. But again, we expect a good increase in Q4. Coming to raw material, the raw material consumption is 54.4% as a percentage of sales compared to 53.40%. And that is due to increase in commodity prices. The employee cost as a percentage of sales is almost same, that is 9.21% compared to 9.16%. The other expenses as a percentage of sales has decreased from 17.33 to 15.87%. We report an EBITDA of 145.47 crores against 122.74 crores. That is an EBITDA margin of 22.52% compared to 21.79%. The interest and finance charges has decreased by 0.82% year on year. That is 10.95 or 94 crores compared to 14.11 crores. Depreciation has increased from 22.03 crores to 24.36 crores. PBT has increased by 27% when comparing Q3 FY21 with Q3 FY20. We recorded a PBT of 110.17 crores compared to 86.60 crores. That is, the PBT margin stands at 17.06% compared to 15.38%. The PAT has increased by 25% from 65 crores to 81 crores. And the percentage margins have increased to 12.61% from 11.55%. So these were the updates for the quarter. If we look at the 9-monthly performance and the period-on-period comparison, despite being a period of pandemic, has shown drastic improvements. Sales from 690 crores in 9-month FY20 has moved to 724 crores in 9-month FY21. The EBITDA margin is 21.40% at 369.03 crores compared to 21.65% at 365.81 crores. We recorded a PBT of 263.12 crores compared to 262.80 crores and PAT margins of 11.20 compared to 13.34%. And profit after tax of 193 crores compared to 225.49 crores. As far as our capex is concerned, the total capex till 31st December 2020 is 180 crores. And the capex plan for the financial year 2021 is 210 crores. As we have told you, our total order book is 1635 crores, comprising of Coal India's order of 535 crores, SCCL 422 crores and defense order book of 678 crores. And working capital days have decreased from 113 days to 107 days. This is all from our end. Now we would be happy to take any questions, comments or suggestions that you may have. Back to you, operator.
Thank you very much, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on your touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. We will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. To ask a question, please press star one. We have a first question from the line of Bharat Shah from ASK Investment Managers. Please go ahead. Mr. Shah, your line is unmuted. Please go ahead and ask your question. Mr. Shah, your line is unmuted. Just going to ask a question. Mr. Shah, your line is unmuted. Please go and ask your question. Mr. Bharat Shah, your line is unmuted, sir. Please go and ask your question. Thank you. As there is no response, we would like to take the next question from the line of Abhishek Ghosh from DSP Mutual Funds. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi, sir. Thanks for the opportunity. So just a couple of questions. If you can just help us understand through your the overall expansion that you've spoken about, what is the quantum kind of capex that you will kind of look at? And where does this kind of confidence is coming for expanding this capacity? Is it more from the domestic and any particular segment, or is it also to do with a lot of exports? Can you just help us understand with that? Thanks.
If you look at the various policies of the government, it is pretty clear that government is pushing investments into infrastructure and housing sectors. And going forward, we can see, and we are visualizing a growth of around 10 to 12% on annual basis as far as demand from housing infrastructure sector is concerned. And as a result of which, we foresee that there will be a big jump in demand from this section. And looking at an overall advantage of putting up plants in various parts of the country, the company have decided that we should expand ourselves from single location, which is based at Nagpur, to produce these products to different parts of the country. That will expand our reach in various parts of the country, and it will definitely help us to increase the customer satisfaction also.
Okay. And sir, what is the kind of quantum one should look at it in terms of the capex outlay and capacity? Can you help us?
The details of the projects is yet to be finalized, but definitely we will share these details in our next quarterly call.
Okay. But the leverage part of it should not increase a lot. Should that one assume that part of it in terms of the overall outlay?
Yeah, that definitely we will take up all these projects based on our overall philosophy, which we have been doing, like overall debt equity ratio should not cross more than 0.5, 0.55, and on capex program which we are doing on annual basis, which was around 242 crores in the past, in this year due to COVID pandemic, now we have decided that it will be around 210 or 215 crores. So the total capex on these projects will be part of our overall capex program.
Okay. That's helpful. Manish, just one more thing. If you can just help us understand, the overall increasing in the geographic expansion that you had done in terms of exports, you had added two, three more countries, and how should one look at it more from a two-to-three perspective? How are they faring? And also, are you also looking to now add more countries in terms of if those new geographies are stabilized?
Yeah, like we have been sharing with you all the people that our foray into overseas markets is in line with our vision to become a global player in the field of explosives. And our vision is very clear and shared with everybody. And as a matter of strategy, we want to expand our geographical reach in various parts of the world. And to give more inputs on that side, we have entered into Africa to start with Nigeria, Zambia, and then we have expanded ourselves in South Africa. And the logic behind that was we want to expand more into the whole African continent. And having ourselves positioned in South Africa will give us an added advantage. Accordingly, we have invested in South Africa. Going forward, like we have already said in shared in the last call, that our Ghana plant is also operationalized. That will help us to expand our presence in the Western African part of the world. And as far as Tanzania is concerned, we are already opened up the entity there, and sales have also started. The project work is going to finish in the month of March, and that will also help us to expand our reach in the Tanzanian market and the nearby places. As far as European part is concerned, we are already present in Turkey, and from Turkey we are expanding to the nearby markets. As far as Australia is concerned, we have been there from last couple of years. Growth in this market is not as per our expectations, but it is part and parcel of the overall business challenges, and we are still pursuing opportunities in that market. We will definitely share more as we move forward. As far as Southeast Asia is concerned, we have already decided a couple of years back that we want to enter into that market, but due to various challenges, we could not enter into that market. But now finally, we have now decided and started taking action, and we will be in Indonesia to start some of the products of our company in the next financial year.
Okay. So the recent good, strong performance, the growth that we are seeing, is it more coming out of any particular region, ramp up of that, Australia or anything else? Because Australia, you mentioned, is not as per your expectations. So is there any other region which is contributing to this good growth that we are seeing in the exports market or the overseas market?
Yeah, the performance from all the subsidiaries are doing much better now compared to the earlier quarters. And as far as any particular territory is concerned, it is not like that. But definitely increased sales from other sections like Ghana, Tanzania and South Africa and Turkey especially, because earlier Turkey was in a economic turmoil sort of things. Now it has improved and stabilized. So that is also helping us to improve our performance.
Okay. And sir, if you can just help us understand the overall raw material movement impact, because we are seeing gross margin seems to have come off as far as most and predominantly for the standalone operations. So is there anything that we should read by in terms of gross margins and the overall increases in the ammonium nitrate prices?
Yeah, you are very right in raising this point of the increasing prices in the commodity section. Definitely, we are also being impacted because of this steep rise. But like we have been saying that our most of the contracts are linked to the raw material prices. So definitely we are getting hit because of this increasing curve. And we believe that in coming quarters we will get advantage of this price rise also. But we are trying our best to overcome this challenge which has come up after the COVID impact. Because in the COVID times, every commodity was available at a damn cheap prices. Now, once the demand is back, the prices are also going up. So we will also may get impacted, but overall, we are confident we will be able to meet this challenge.
And sir, is there a supply chain disruption in availability of ammonium nitrate or anything? Is there a supply chain disruption that you are witnessing?
Yeah, after the Beirut blast, definitely the regulations are more tightened as far as ammonium nitrate is concerned. We are also impacted because of that. The supply is also dried up, and as a result, there is a shortage of ammonium nitrate. But now it has started improving, and in a couple of months it will settle.
And do you think so you are a large scale, you're the largest scale player with that 20-25% kind of market share. Do you think the weaker players or not so organized players are getting a little weaker in this entire environment today where there's a supply chain disruption and other things? Is that something that is happening in the marketplace?
Definitely, since basically it has two sides of the story. First is that since we are more organized, we have contracts with the customer. Definitely, since we are the leading player, we have to obey the contractual commitments also or fulfill the contractual commitment. So on one side, we have better control on the supply side of raw material, but on another side, we have to also fulfill the contractual terms. Whereas on as far as unorganized players are concerned, they don't have the contracts on supply side. At the same time, they can they may get out of the contractual terms also. So on overall basis, we believe that it's a challenging situation, and we are doing better than others.
Great. Okay, sir. Thank you so much for answering my questions, and wish you and your team all the luck. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Participants who wishes to ask a question at this time, may press star followed by one on your touchtone phone now. We have next question from the lineup, Rohan Gupta from Edelweiss Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi, sir. Good afternoon. So thanks for the opportunity. Sir, a couple of questions. First is on our CapEx plan. Sir, you mentioned that though company so far now has been concentrated on single location, but now you are looking at multiple locations. Sir, I understand that you have still to chalk down the complete plans. Just wanted to understand, sir, will it be driving our margins? Because I believe that the one plant, single location, we have economies of scale, or we are going to get benefit of the transportation cost benefit. And also, if you can just give some color on that, at least minimum capex for a one plant will be roughly how much, sir, location-wise?
Yeah. So, like I said, that the details of the project, the location, and the overall capex will be shared in coming quarters. But on an overall basis, while we decide on expanding ourselves from one location to, say, multiple locations, definitely we have to do the network analysis, demand supply scenarios for each region. And definitely, whenever we will decide, it will be decided on overall commercial benefit to the company. So we will definitely balance the capex part and the return on capital employed side. At the same time, we have to enhance the customer reach also.
Okay, so that I fairly understand that that we will be doing a fair amount of exercise before getting into that. My question was, sir, that what is the minimum requirement and minimum investment which we have to start with while getting into any location, sir?
I cannot answer your question at this moment, but whenever we will freeze all these plans, I will share with everybody.
Okay. Sir, second question is on our export revenues and also slightly taking over from the previous participant also. So, sir, we have this quarter done great revenues from the export revenue, export market, probably the highest ever seen in many quarters. You have always guided that you are looking 1,000 crore turnover kind of from the export market by FY22. I think that with the current run rate itself, it's pretty much achievable. Sir, do you see that with the pickup in all the export market, and as you mentioned that almost countries across the markets are doing well and contributing to the revenue, so can we see that there is a faster pickup in these markets and can lead to maybe a 1200 crore kind of annual turnover by next year from these export revenues, sir? If you can give any guidance on that.
Sure. Since we are quite optimistic as far as our business from export and overseas is concerned, that is what I have shared also. But we should also not forget the challenges which has been created because of the pandemic in many parts of the world, especially African side. And there are challenges as far as currency availability is concerned in many parts of the world. So these are challenges, but we are optimistic that looking at the upturn in the overseas business, which we have seen in from last 2-3 quarters, will continue in coming year as well. And based on our efforts and visibility, at the same time, considering the realistic situation also, which can also change. So we are optimistic that we will definitely cross 1,000 crores in the next financial year.
Okay, and so next question, if I may ask, and sir, on a domestic growth, that volume growth for the quarter has been roughly muted, and I think that there has been some change in the reporting system also, because last year the reported volumes were higher, at roughly explosive volume was close to 95,719 range. I think there has been some change in reporting system. But even on the, looking at the presentation, the volume growth for the quarter has been almost nil. While we have seen that some of the sectors in the economy has picked up very well, especially from the cement and other infrastructure related activities and also in the Coal India, probably that is not getting reflected in our volume growth numbers. Do you see that there is any particular reason, or we are still living under the impact of COVID in some of the markets and some of the regions are not contributing to this? Just some elaboration on that.
So as far as demand from housing infra is concerned, wherever we are present, we have not lost any market, first of all. Second, the demand from this sector have reached to the pre-COVID level. That is what I have also shared. And accordingly, we are meeting the customer requirement. But at the same time, definitely there was disruption to some extent in availability of our raw material. That has also impacted the sales of these products to our customers. But now, since the situation has improved compared to the previous quarter, definitely we will see more sales of explosives in this Q4.
So you are saying that raw material challenges means that there was a shortage of AM and that has caused some loss of some of the volume which we could not do?
As far as ammonium nitrate is concerned, like I said, there was some disruption that has resulted into this kind of less supply of product, or we could not produce what was the demand in the market. But these things keep happening in the market and people get settled. So I am pretty, based on our experience of the past, in Q4 we will deliver better than the Q3, and Q4 will definitely be better than the last year Q4, which was impacted due to COVID. And going forward, we believe that demand will be very good and we could be able to meet the demand from Q1 of the next financial year to the best possible.
And so just last bit on defense, I think last quarter you mentioned that the revenue recognition for the multi-mode hand grenade will happen in a Q4. Just wanted to get some update on that and on overall defense business, that how the pickup is happening on the multi-mode hand grenade also, and where do you see that our revenue for the defense business going in the next year, sir?
Yeah, we are pleased to share that we have received an order, which we have discussed in the previous call. After that, we have to supply some quantity to the various testing agencies, which we have also completed in the previous month. And the product have passed all the parameters. And accordingly, we are likely to receive the final green signal. Or in a contractual terminology, we say that it's a bulk production clearance, which we are going to receive very soon. And once we get it, we will start the production and supply of this product. As far as other orders or other products from defense application is concerned, we have already started production of those things. Only because of deferment of supply in the previous quarter, it get delayed. That will reflect in the Q4 numbers. As far as next year, sales from next year is concerned, we are quite optimistic that whatever delays we have seen in the previous year will not be reflected in next year. From next year, we are quite optimistic. Sales from defense product will be on track, and we will see many more orders coming in the next year, probably next year.
But now, since you have already started supplying multi-mode hand grenade and already got order, I think it was roughly 500 crore opportunities cumulatively for next 2 years. Do you see that there is any change or any further spillover in that? And if not, then can we expect almost 400 to 500 crore rupees revenue from the multi-mode hand grenade only next 2 years cumulative?
Sir, I'm sorry to interrupt. Please stay connected. This is the operator. We lost the line of the management. We're reconnecting the management. Please stay connected. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, kindly stay connected. Ladies and gentlemen, we now have the line back for the management. We apologize for the interruption. Sir, we are back in the call. We have Mr. Gupta continuing with his question. Sir, please repeat your question. Thank you.
Sir, thanks. And just last from my side, sir, I was asking that now since we have already got order from the Multimove and Grenade, and it was roughly 500 crore opportunity over next 2 years cumulatively. Do you see that there will be any delays on that? Or spillovers, or we are going to capture this entire opportunity in next 2 years, sir?
We will definitely not miss this opportunity, and we are confident that in next 2 years we will deliver the full quantity. We have already geared up everything, whatever is required for this order.
So it means that roughly maybe 200 and 300 will be split maybe in revenue for next 2 years, if I'm assuming rightly on that.
Yeah, you are not wrong on this assumption.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thanks a lot. And I'll get back to you for any further follow-up. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Ji.
Thank you, sir. A reminder to participants to ask a question, please press star followed by one on your touchtone phone now. We have next question from the line of Sagar Naik from Equintas Wealth Advisory Services.
Hello, good afternoon everyone. Congratulations on a great set of numbers. So first one is, you know, housing and infra segment has also picked up now and, you know, has grown well this quarter. So how much of this would be due to, you know, pent-up demand that has now materialized, and how much would be sustainable going forward?
Thank you very much. As far as demand from housing infra is concerned, we don't see that it's a pent-up demand. We believe that it will be sustained in the quarters to come.
Okay, okay. And sir, commodity costs have increased. You mentioned that is the reason for, you know, the impact on gross margins. But, you know, our realization is flat quarter on quarter as well as year on year. So, you know, are we negotiating price hikes now?
Like I said, that most of our contracts are linked to the raw material prices. So as prices will go up, we will also increase our finished good prices. There can be some delay of a month or 1.5 months if something is linked to a particular date. Apart from that, we are quite comfortable, and we will manage, we will be able to manage the situation.
Okay, okay. As for Ghana, what were the sales in this quarter and, you know, year-on-year and quarter-on-quarter growth, if you could give?
As a matter of policy, we don't share the revenue from each country on quarterly basis.
So just if you can share the growth numbers. Last quarter, you mentioned it was something around 18%.
So this year we have around 27% of growth coming from overseas and export.
Okay. And sir, on this CapEx front, you know, what is the current capacity and utilization level for package explosives?
The capacities we have has multiple products and various plants. So it is not possible to give one figure of capacity utilization for each line of product or each campus. So whatever capacity utilization we share in our annual report, that you can see in our next annual report.
Okay, fine. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Participants who wishes to ask a question may press star followed by one on your touchtone phone now. We have next question from the line of Amit Zare from Antique Stock Broking. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, team, and thanks for the opportunity. Just wanted to understand, is there any impact of currency depreciation in our overseas markets? I think there have been steep currency fluctuations in African countries and all. So is there any impact on us of that?
So there has been some translation loss, and if we talk about this quarter to quarter, if we compare, then the total impact on sales is around 11.5 crores. And when we talk about 9 months, the total impact is about 97 crores.
Okay, so impact of 97 crores for the 9 months.
Yeah.
Got it. Thank you.
Thank you. Participants who wishes to ask a question may press star followed by one on your touchtone phone now. We have a next question from the line of Santosh Yelappu, an investor. Please go ahead.
Congratulations on good set of numbers, sir. Thank you for the opportunity to ask this question. I had a few questions. First, let me understand, sir, what is...
Sir, I'm sorry to interrupt, Mr. Santosh. Your line is not very clear, sir. Please use the handset. Maybe try to ask again.
Is this fine, sir?
No, we still have... the audio is still not clear.
Okay. How is it clear, sir?
No, there seem to be network.
Hello.
But I would request if you can dial back again and join the queue again. Thank you. We have next question from the lineup, Sujit Jain from ASK Investment Managers. Please go ahead.
Manish, Nilesh, and Mr. Menon, our compliments on a very solid set of numbers. In the beginning of the pandemic, you had said that we'll match previous year's performance, and at the PBT level, you've already matched it. I have a question. Then, therefore, you had indicated, looking at the COVID situation in your last call, you might aim at 15-20% kind of a growth for next year, if the situation does not worsen. Are we on track for that?
Yes, we are on track of that for the next financial year. We expect around, on a conservative side, we expect a growth of 15%.
And now that all things are falling in place in terms of the capex that you've done in defense, which for many years did not yield revenues, but now everything is falling in place in terms of order book as well. In over the medium term, can we expect now a solid double-digit growth 3 to 5 years?
Yes, we are quite optimistic and confident that we will achieve those sets of numbers.
That is good to hear. And you have explained that you will not breach debt to equity of 0.5. We are already at about 740 crores, 720 crores versus 1500 crores of equity. So though you are yet to give your details about the capex plan, but then we can presume if you were not to breach those levels, most of the capex will be funded through internal accruals.
Yes, this is our plan that we will meet most of our CapEx requirements from internal accrual only.
Sure. And the working capital numbers, I missed, if you can, give that again.
Sure. It is now 107 days compared to 113 days on a comparable quarter.
A QOQ compared to last quarter, sequentially, you are saying?
Sorry, on 31st March 20, it was 113 days. Now it is 107 days.
Sure. And then now that defense will eventually become a good portion of revenues, do you see this working capital cycle getting slightly stretched? Or here also, you have some targets in mind which will not breach?
We don't have kept a specific target which we will hit. But definitely, like we have been saying, that 100, 110 days should be ideal number which we will follow. And we believe that despite of increase in sales of products for defense, we will maintain the number of days.
Sure. And South Africa and Australia, the losses, and you indicated that this year there will be profits. How has been the progress there?
As far as Australia is concerned, our project has not yet started, but sales have definitely improved, and we will share the detailed numbers in our annual call.
And South Africa?
Yeah, the same thing is applicable for South Africa also. The business has started improving, and now we are in a much better position compared to the previous quarter or previous year. And things will definitely keep on improving now onwards.
Sure. Thank you and good luck to you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We have next question from the line of Bharat Gupta from Edelweiss Securities. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Thanks for the opportunity and congratulations for a good set of results. My question pertains, like you have mentioned in the opening remarks, that there has been some deferment of sales in the export side. So can you give the quantum of it?
No. We said deferment of sales on defense side. Exports is going pretty well.
Okay, rightly, sir. So is there any quantum, like can you specify what was the exact contribution which got spread over to Q4?
What we were expecting is a good 60 to 70 crores of defense sales every quarter, which is we were not able to achieve because of deferment from the customers.
Right, sir. And second, my second question pertains to the ROC side. So, sir, we have seen that the ROC have diluted to nearly 20-odd% for FY20. So, going forward, what kind of visibility we have where we can reach by to either to 25% odd levels? So, do we have that kind of a visibility going ahead where we can improve on the margins and on the ROC side?
So, our ROC did got impacted because of this COVID pandemic, because of previous year in 20, we did lose sales and profits. But now, as we said, we are back on track and we are expecting a good sales and EBITDA margin. So our EBITDA will be back on track at 25% plus EBITDA. EBITDA, sorry, this ROC.
Yeah, that's it from my side, sir. Thank you and wish you all the good luck.
Thank you. Participants who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on your touchtone phone now. We have next question from the line of Manish Mahawar from Antique Stock Broking. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hello. Am I audible?
Yes, you are. Hello. Please go ahead.
Yeah, so just the first question is on in terms of institutional business, we are consistently seeing the decline in the revenue. Manish, can you give us some throw some light on the institutional business, please?
The sales from institutional sector has reduced mainly because of the COVID impact in the first two quarters. Now we will see improvement from Q4 onwards.
Okay. But the institutional also consists of Singhania, I believe, right?
Yes.
Okay. But sir, if Singhania tender was supposed to be rainbow in this year, so it has been happened and...
Yeah, the tender is completed. We had shared that information on the stock exchange. Yeah.
Okay. And the second question, sir, in terms of Manish, is there any probability in our margin side over longer term, I'm saying next 18 to 24 months, do you see our EBITDA margin can improve?
So in this quarter itself, if you see, it is around 22.5. And as we proceed ahead with good export overseas and defense sales, definitely there will be some margin improvement.
Okay. But any ballpark number like peak margin we can make in this business?
The things globally, things are moving in the way which we see day in and day out. We can just comment there will be improvement, but very difficult to come across a particular digit or a number.
Okay. Again, in this EBITDA margin, Manish, what I recall earlier, in terms of our raw mat sourcing, or we are most of the raw mat we are backward integrated except ammonium nitrate. Is this true at the moment, or we are still have a sourcing some raw mat apart from ammonium nitrate from outside?
So ammonium nitrate, yes, we are sourcing from outside. Other than that, we have capacities. Most of them we are making in-house. But at times when we get it at a better price compared to our in-house production cost, we do buy a source from there as well.
Okay, understood. And the last question, sir, in terms of overseas revenue, you said 1,000 crores of revenue in the FY22, right, sir, in overseas?
Yes.
And this is excluding export revenue, right? This is purely overseas subsidies number, what we're talking about.
Excluding exports.
Okay. And can it possible, Manish, to share maybe next 3 year number for possibly this 1,000 crores of revenue when you're talking about FY22 in next 3 year, what could be the number?
So 15% growth year on year we are expecting.
Okay, understood. And Nilesh, last question from my side. In terms of translator's loss, when you said around 11.5 crores, this is our revenue as well as EBITDA, right, for the quarter?
Yeah, so when sales revenue gets affected, similarly EBITDA levels will also get affected, and so will be the profit levels.
Okay, sure. Thank you, sir, and all the best.
Thank you. A reminder to participants, if you wish to ask a question, please press star followed by one on your touchtone phone now. We have next question from the line of Sujit Chen from ASK Investment Managers. Please go ahead.
Yes, thank you for the opportunity again. Just to clarify, then in South Africa, Australia and Ghana, earlier we had indicated that we will break even in FY21. Are we on track?
In Ghana, yes, we are on track. We have already reached to a break-even level. In South Africa, we will be expecting break-even in Q4.
And in Australia? Australia, you're saying when operations resume, you'll immediately see a quick break-even, right?
No, I have not said that. I said that in next financial year, we will start the operations, and our trading operation have already started, and sales by exporting out of India has increased compared to the last year. And once projects start, definitely within a year's time, we will reach to the break-even number. So probably what you are asking is when we will reach to break-even number. So yes. I am saying in next couple of months, we will start the project, and after that, it will take at least an year time to reach to a break-even number.
Get that. Thank you. And in terms of the exports and overseas number total for 9 months, which is about 753 crores, how much is export, how much was overseas?
We just always have a combined figure for that. You don't give us a breakup as a policy.
Sure, but then when we say that we can cross thousands of exports,
thousands of overseas revenue.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. We have next question from the line of Chirag Muchhala from Nirmal Bang Equities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, sir, two questions from me. Firstly, on the Coal India order book, so which is currently at around 535 crores. So this is executable over what period, and is there any next tender coming up shortly from Coal India?
The Coal India tenders are till November month, and we expect that after 3-4 months, they will float the tender.
Okay, so this 535 crore is to be delivered till November 2021.
No, this tender value includes the quantity for Singareni Collieries also. No, Coal India, you are asking for, I was sharing that we have 2-3 orders which are ending on different dates, but the major, one of the major order, which is bulk explosives, is going to end by 1st of November or the 31st of October, and once it is over, they will float a new tender. So sometime they extend the tenders also. So it depends where, how they will float and when they will float. But normally they float tenders 2-3 months before it gets concluded. But maybe due to COVID, they may extend by another 2-3 months time.
Okay, sir, and the second and last question from me on the Pinaka rocket, sir. So is there any further update on that? The government had placed the order for hardware, you know, to on the vehicle suppliers, but any further update on when the orders for the missiles is coming?
As far as order is concerned, they have yet to place any RFP for these products, but definitely things are going in the right direction. Since they have already placed orders for hardware, definitely they have to float RFP for the ammunition also. So we believe that in a quarter or two quarters, they should float RFP for Pinaka rocket, for which we are a production and nominated production agency, apart from another PSU.
Okay. So basically, it will be split only between us and the Ordnance Factory Board, right, sir?
Yeah, they normally give orders to the production nominated production agencies.
Okay.
And as far as nominated production agencies are concerned, for this product, Ordnance Factory and our subsidiary Economic Explosives is a nominated agency.
Okay. No, sir, so my question was that either of the two will get it, or they will split between the two in whatever ratio they decide.
These details will come in RFP only, na? Once they float RFP, then only we can see whether they will put a condition of only one player, or they will put a condition of two players, or what will be the ratio between these two players or one player, whatever it is. So I can answer those questions once RFP is out.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir, that's it from me.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. As there are no further questions from the participants, I'd now like to hand the conference over to Mr. Chirag Muchhala from Nirmal Bang Equities for closing comments. Over to you, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Vikram. We thank the management for taking time out and sharing their valuable insights on this call, and we also thank all the participants for their presence. Sir, do you have any closing remarks?
Yeah. On behalf of the entire Solar team, we would like to thank everyone for participating in this conference call. And if you have any further questions or suggestions, you can please directly mail it to us, or you can contact Chirag and he can always connect us with you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.